Yo, Mac, I don't even understand how they didn't understand you and that Mary joint.
Yeah, I
kick
know,
that
man.
Old robotic, futuristic George Jetson
crazy joint.
From cities and towns all over this land. The amber waves of the Kansas wheat to the tough back alleys of the city streets. There beats the heart of the aspiring young rock. Wherever there's a flat piece of ground in this country, you'll find a pack of kids playing football. And out of that crowd, there emerges one runner who is special. At age 10, he's the first pick when choosing upside. By 16, he's a high school star and a hometown legend. As a young man, he finds himself a college hero, the pride of his state. And if he's truly gifted, he'll become a pro. But if he is one in 10 million, he will leave all the voices behind. For only then will he become one of the best ever. He is a king on a cruise, cast in a spell, we all wear his shoes. His heroic course is clear, and like him, we too are without fear. He's the champion of his quest, and we too have beaten the rest. He hypnotizes with his stylish grace. We all admire his artful pace. He is a thoroughbred alone on the track. A graceful wonder who outdistances. But there comes a time when men gallop away, when we cannot emulate. We can only say that they are superstars, capable of any endeavor, and only they may be called the best.
This is Eric McCoo. Welcome to the Cool Highlight Film. I hope you enjoy it.
Started playing in Red Bank when I was about 6 years old. The reason I started playing because one of the many options to do, you know, I wanted to play a lot of sports, you know, keep out of trouble and stuff, so that's one of the things I did.
My father inspired me to play football, you know. He inspired me to stick with it because things wasn't going the way I wanted them to, and I was playing on the line and everything, so he said just keep what I'm doing and everything will work out fine, you know, and it did. Eventually, I got in the backfield my last year at Pop Warner, and from then on, I never got out.
Number seven. I chose number seven because it's been a long line of great running backs that wore number seven at Red Bank Regional, and, you know, such as Baku. Thor. One that stuck in my mind the most was Baku because I watched him play. You know, I didn't really get to see those other guys play. I saw him, but I was a little kid, you know, coming to the games with my grandfather and things. But, you know, seeing Baku wear the number, he came very close to it. You know, he was a great running back, had nobody else wear it again. But, you know, since Sully kept the number, you know, I felt that I should wear it and try to be the last one to wear the number to make sure no one wore it again because the tradition lived on long enough. As I was saying, it's been a long line of great running backs wearing number seven. The person I got it from was Baku Thor.
He's a special person, man. He has unbelievable talent. I've never seen in my life before. And since he went to Red Bank Regional, he was under me. I noticed the talent. I used to always hear when going to the games, Baku Ho, Baku Ho. It's a new man in town. And it sounds just like my name. The reason I handed number seven to Eric McCoo is I want number seven tradition to live on. People used to ask me, well, what happened? You have Eric McCoo and Baku in the backfield at the same time.
Let me ask you this question. what would you do if you had two Mack trucks coming down the street at the same time?
Get out the way
or get ran over? Guess we'll never know. All I need is 2 inches of daylight, 4.2 seconds to reach the end zone.
Barry Sanders is the one that I look up to as far as a running back. You know, I see him, I watch his moves, I study him, and I try to perfect his moves, you know, make them better, to make me a lot better. And I would have to say Barry Sanders is the one that I look up to as a running back. Barry Sanders, I try to use a lot of his moves, but, you know, I got to have some of my own. And I think that stiff arm is my own, you know, little thing. And I think I took the stiff arm to a new level. It was, I guess you could say, my special year, besides my senior year, which was very special. But it's special because my main objective, I was supposed to be playing the fullback. I was supposed to be the number one fullback, and I was. But Kareem Brown got hurt. And I had to move to tailback. I had to make a change to tailback. And that just took my career to a new level. You know, I became the tailback, and I played most of the games at tailback. He had a bad senior year, so he was hurt off and on, you know, a recurring injury. And I just kept being a tailback, and from then on, I just never got out of the backfield at tailback. But I would say I had a great sophomore year, but I'll let you be the judge of that.
Sheep, my man, yo, say, who's the red man? Where's the red man? I killed G. chill, Lock. Sober, man. Yo, you don't gotta say no more. It's over.
But you like that? That was just a little bit just to come.